Well, howdy, folks. I've been gone, right? I ain't been around for a little bit. Well, I've been around. I've just been really super busy. And I got a question today twice. Not once, but twice. And it comes in a lot. And I've talked about this before. We've talked about adding a grill to a cart and how to add a grill to a cart. Well, we've talked mostly about how to change over a water system, because a lot of carts come with a water system that is a passive system. The older carts had passive systems. It was gravity fed. It ran through a little tube by the burners and then out your spigot, but really slow and really undependable. Well, now most carts come with a on-demand system, right? So the reason I'm doing this today is because of the questions about adding a grill. And a lot of people, you know, they'll email me and go, "Ben, can I buy one of your grills?" You don't have to buy one of my grills, okay? I could probably sell a buttload of grills, but the truth is you can do it yourself and it's cheaper. And you can get the kind of grill you want. But let me tell you what you do first. Hey, Mick, glad you're here. So what you would do first is you can simply Google, and you may want to write this down, a portable or suitcase stainless steel grill. And this time of year, they are abundant, okay? So Lowe's, Home Depot, Walmart, Gander Mountain, everybody's got some, right? Now you get closer to the fall and get out of grilling season, they go away. But all it is a portable grill. Okay, most of the manufacturers out there are adding a stainless steel, that way it's food safe and it's non-porous and it looks sexy with a stainless steel cart, is they'll put on a stainless steel grill, but it's just a portable grill, okay? Blue Rhino is the manufacturer pretty much for all those, but they're importing them in from China. So, but they private label them. So when you get one of those grills, more than likely, no matter what name's on it, Blue Rhino is the company that made them, and they come out of China. But they're still good grills. And some are better than others, and some you can spend a whole bunch of money on, but typically, $100 sometimes you'll find them for. I've seen them at Lowe's for $89. The same grill, okay? Now, the only thing, adaptation you'll need, if you have room on top of your cart, it's really simple, okay? You can turn the legs upside down and put them, you know, bolt them onto your top. You'll need a good stainless steel drill bit, something that'll go through stainless steel, and mark the places where the legs are going to hit, and then drill through the legs and through the top of the cart. The other thing you would need to do is, if you are planning on putting it off to the side of the cart, like attached to the cart but off to the side, is there several ways. You've seen me interview Frankenstein several times out of Waynesville, North Carolina. And one something he did is he built his own little rack for his grill, and then he doubled it to put two grills up there. And how he did that is with a TV mount. You can buy TV mounts, $23 I think they are right now. I mean, you'll find them even cheaper. But $23, you can get a good TV mount. And you can mount that to the side of your cart, bolt it on. It bolts into a wall, so it'll bolt on the side of your cart, and it will swing out. And that way you can travel with it over the cart, and then it swings out next to you when you're serving. Those swinging ones are great. It's smart. It's simple. I've seen some vendors use normal just pole mounts like you see a satellite dish on, like DirecTV or Dish Network dish, one of those little J-tubes and a mount. I've seen some vendors use those. It really doesn't take that much. Now, if you're not handy, okay, like me, and you don't have a Keith like me who can do this kind of stuff, you can go to a fabrication shop, but it's cheaper just to call a handyman off of Craigslist or something. You get a handyman. Hey, David, you get a handyman to come out to you, or you meet him somewhere. He can attach that and hook you right up. Okay, and then he's going to use his drill bits and stuff, makes it a lot easier, and you don't have to worry about breaking drill bits, because those tougher, hardened steel drill bits are a little more expensive. Now, one of the things you'll also need to do is run a gas line. And here's where people get confused. And people make mistakes. They'll put on a grill, call me up, Ben, don't know what to do. Well, grills come, typically these portable grills, they call them suitcase grills or camping grills, the stainless steel ones, they'll come with the little adapter off the side so you can screw on one of those one-pound tanks, little one-pound propane tank. Well, you don't want to use a one-pound tank. You want to hook it into your normal gas tank, right? So there's two things you'll need, and it's really pretty easy. Some of those stainless steel grills will come with an adapter, so you can either do a regular LP gas line directly to it, like you would for your home grill, or you can buy an adapter and put it on there. Then at the other end, you remember on most hot dog carts, especially mobile kitchens, you will have coming out of the propane tank a regulator and one hose running to your burners, right? Well, what you'll do is you'll buy a LP gas line splitter, okay? So what happens, it comes out of that tank and it splits. It just splits like this. And then the one, you just hook your regulator and hose going to where it was going. And over here, you hook your new hose up with no regulator going up to the regulator that's on your grill. Now, if your grill doesn't have a regulator, then you can split it off the regulator that you already have. Okay? So you can Y it after the regulator coming out of the tank. If you try to double regulate it though, if you come out of the tank and you have a regulator here and you split after the regulator and you go over here to your burners and over here you're going to your grill and it's got a regulator, probably ain't gonna work. You're going to have a mess, and it's going to be a pain in the butt, and it's going to cause you headaches. So if you're not handy, get a handyman, okay? Call one up, Craigslist, Facebook, find you a good handyman. It won't cost you much to put one on. You can do the whole process yourself for less than $200, okay? Some people have done it even cheaper than that, $150. You find a grill for $89, and you find the line. We've got some of these resources at learnhotdogs.com/resources. If you need to find out about the why, I've bought them before at Amazon, okay? But I've got the links there for you if you want them. It's really not that hard to add a grill to a cart. You'll want to check, though, with your state health inspector, your inspector that checks you now, and say, hey, can I have a grill? Some of them will say, well, as long as it's got a lid on it. As long as you can close it and open it, right? Because they want it protected from overhead debris, mostly bird poop. So that's it. That's my son that's walking back and forth right there. So anyway, not a real big deal. And if you have questions like this, even if I can't answer them, what I'll do typically is I'll ask Keith, my partner, and I'll say, Keith, how do you do this? And he'll explain it to me, and then I'll relay that information to you, even if I don't know how even understand it. This one I do understand, and it's not that hard of a deal. And if you're handy at all, you can get this done in an afternoon, a couple hours, and you will have a grill on your hot dog cart. It's a great way to go. I want to tell everybody I missed you. I did. I appreciate all the kind comments and stuff. I've been seeing a lot of those. Let's see here. Sunshine Network TV. Thanks, Ben. Love you, brother. Thanks for the info. I'm up and coming vendor. Terry's Big Dogs and Catering. I love it. I love it. I love it. I like the fact that you used Big Dogs and Catering. The catering is key. So Artie Rodriguez, let's see here. Artie says, hello, Ben, everyone here. Life Gives Lemons and Catering is entering final stages to be up and running. Thanks so much, Ben and the VU family. If you don't know what the VU is, in fact, I'm in a hurry because at 9 o'clock we start a live training. We do an exclusive line training for Vendors United members. You do not have to be a vendor yet, kind of like Artie, okay? But there's about 50-something members in there who ain't vending yet. They're getting their ducks in a row, or they're waiting for their job to end, and they are retirement, or whatever. Everybody's got something they're waiting on, and they're getting their ducks in a row, or whatever, licensing and crap, waiting on a cart to come in, and they then will start. Well, the Vendors United is a fantastic place. If you want to learn stuff, there's no commitment. It's $27 a month. It's dirt cheap. It's fixing to go up. So if you get the $27 now, you get to keep it. But it's fixing to go up. And what you'll be able to do in there is get help from pros and even new people coming in. Corey with O'Doggies, y'all have seen him before. I did an interview with him several times. He's been around for a long time. He's on every show we've ever done. He is an amazing vendor. Him and his wife do an amazing job. He started with a home-built cart. You can find out about that, buildacart.com. He built a cart, and then he turned around, and let me see if I can get this to move that, all right? So he turned around and bought another cart, then he bought an enclosed trailer, and then he got a restaurant, and he's still vending on the street. He's doing it all. The guy, I don't think, sleeps. So there's so much. He's helped family members out. He's, amazing vendor. But these are the kind of people that are in there helping each other. It is fantastic. In fact, some of the pros, like Jason Brown, just got back yesterday from vacation. How in the hell does a vendor go on vacation during peak season? Because they can. And if you want access to all that good information so you don't have any learning curves, this mess, $27, I guarantee you that it will pay for itself day one, day two, day... It'll keep paying for itself. It's just like... And it's why people get in there and they don't leave. Unless you're just not going to vend at all, there's no point in it, right? It's like buying chocolate ice cream. You don't like chocolate or ice cream. Let's see. Morgan Crowley's in the house, Fairweather Hot Dogs and Catering. Bubba D. Catering on board. Glad to see you. Thank you, Sunshine Network TV. I like that, Riley. Being the Institute of Justice has been such a big help. Thanks for the advice. Absolutely, Riley, and I'm glad they've helped you. They're great people. He says, Riley says, even, I love this, even had the city attorney call me and say, yeah, I think we're in violation. Yeah, you think? Folks, I've learned so much even after having been in the business. Already again, folks, I've learned so much even after having been in the biz for decades. I highly recommend the small tax write-off investment. It's not a huge investment, but for some people, $27, still $27. That's like two Happy Meals and a bag of burritos, right, for Taco Bell. So I get it. But I can tell you, if you have the goal of being independent, getting your freedom, self-sufficient. I was writing a email today, and if you're on my email list, you'll get this. But the difference between having, you can have your, more money. More money, usually we all can figure out how to make more money. You work more, right? You take another job and another job, or you work overtime, you do all that, but you sacrifice that at the cost of freedom. And I've done that. You might have done that. And it's not worth it. And that's why hot dogs saved my life. It's a longer story than that, but it saved my life. But anyway, if you have any interest in joining, it's learnhotdogs.com/join, and it's a video that'll tell you what it's about. It'll tell you more than I just told you. Richard Stewart, Swooper Flags. Swooper Flags, the best place I know of to get there, there's two places, and I'm going to tell you to check both, because sometimes one will be cheaper than the other. Amazon is dynamite on them. Dynamite, okay? Usually you can get the 15-footers, say hot dogs or a picture of a hot dog, something like that. Really, really inexpensive. eBay, every now and then, you'll find a really good deal on eBay. Like, they'll say 2-for-1 price or something crazy. So check both of those and type in Swooper Flag or Flutter Flag or Flag Banner with Pole. That may help you. And that will give you access to some cheap marketing that continues to pay for itself. You buy it once and it just works every day. It's a great way to do it. But thanks for the question. Let me see. I don't know why this stupid thing is jacked up today. Morgan, this place is it's my office and my home, and it is a It was built in 1952, and the concrete behind that brick is just a facade. It's real brick, but it's just a facade. You know, it's fake. Not fake, but it's just a fascia, basically. And it's total thickness, 14 inches poured concrete. So it's super thick. It's hard to drill a hole. I had to run a fiber optic line, and I watched him go through a couple drill bits getting through. Anyway, I love you, and I wish you the most and the bestest and all that good stuff. But we have a new site that is, you can go to streetfoodpro.com, streetfoodpro.com. If you're new and thinking about the business, that is something new I made for you, okay? And it might give you some encouragement and help you see the different ways to get this done, and show you how to do this fail-proof, guaranteed, make it happen. All the information there is free. Take a look at it. If you got a friend thinking about the business, or you got a friend that needs some peace of mind and freedom and a real income, send them over there at streetfoodpro.com. Anyway, hope you have a good evening. Talk to you.